years ago, has now surrendered in Sydney. Known to unsuspecting locals as Dougie, he blames COVID for making life on the run too hard.
Darko Dezic did hard time behind bars, but life outside, even in these surroundings, wasn't easy. 3 decades after he escaped from life in jail, the 64-year-old gave himself up at D-Y Police Station.
It's amazing that lockdown will be...
It was. He wasn't happy. I'm in this.
He was sentenced to 3 years for growing cannabis, and a year in, he used a hacksaw to break out. Since then, he's been lying low in Avalon, working as a handyman known as Dougie. But when the pandemic hit, he lost his jobs, his income, his home.
Like, always certainly when I come in here.
Dezic is once again locked up, set to finish his original sentence. But one former detective believes his initial jail time was enough.
I don't think he should be punished any further, and I don't think the system will want to anyway.
The night before Dezic went to police, he slept here on Avalon Beach. It's understood he told officers he was homeless, broke, and believed a prison cell with a bed and 3 meals a day was his only option. That could be his outlook for the next 13 months. Natasha Slary, 7 News.
An explosive new book has shed more light on the chaotic final days of the Trump presidency. Written by veteran journalist Bob Woodward, the book investigates fears of all-out war with China. It claims Donald Trump's top general was so worried he called his Chinese counterpart twice to reassure him the US wasn't going to strike. Donald Trump says it's one of the most ridiculous things he's ever heard. Explosions have rocked a town in Bolivia. More than a dozen people were injured when a small fire ignited a gas cylinder. It then sparked a diesel tank blast. It took firefighters more than 5 hours to bring the inferno under control. Police are hunting down a driver who disappeared in a very conspicuous puff of smoke. Police say the red Commodore spewed out the celebration through several streets, making it hard for other drivers to see. They are still trying to identify the driver. A man has escaped jail after making threats to kill police horses just ahead. Why these pictures triggered his outburst and the lockdown rule that he claims tipped him over the edge. Broadway's back. New York's theatre hub reopens to all, but there's one catch. From free tolls to phone credits, the company's offering big bonuses for getting vaccinated.
And ahead in sport, a rare look at the softer side of one of rugby league's hardest men.
I'm really sorry for giving you the wrong idea, but I think you want more and I don't. Hey, thanks for the rose, you're looking for my bullshit.
I got mine. Mine started on the 1st. Last year, we paid, and it goes to the 15th. travel permits are going to be extended till the 30th of December. September.
Yeah, I'm redecorating. It's called taste. Look it up.
From the 3rd of September.
The 3rd of September, Daddy?
That'll be extended to the 30th of September. Mine's from the 1st of September to the 15th, so it should be right, shouldn't it?
Your Ford dealer does. Which is why
current travel hold
permits. We're still here to help. With contactless sales inquiries, service, and repairs. Discover how much more you get with Ford. Speak to a dealer today.
I have a carrot one, it should be from the first, yeah. Take a leave my phone, please.
Mummy, I need your phone, please.
Don't let the government take your freedom. Vote them out.